special meeting to see if we can resolve our elections. So, Mr. Moderator, would you like to just start this?
I'd be glad to.
The town clerk, where is our town clerk?
I'm not comfortable with the videoing. Thank you. I don't want to be videotaped. I'll sit back here.
So, with thanks and apologies to everybody for all the emails over the weekend. Beginning on Friday, I began receiving inquiries about what our plans were in the event of bad weather on Tuesday, March 14th, the day scheduled for town elections. And the initial inquiry was whether we could give out a lot more absentee ballots today for folks that were worried about traveling tomorrow. An initial review of the absentee ballot statute suggested to me that you know, it would be town moderators, or town clerk's decision what to do, but it didn't look like bad weather is a statutory basis to receive an absentee ballot. And as the weekend progressed, the weather predictions got worse and worse. I participate in a listserv for New Hampshire moderators. That's really an excellent resource. It's connected through the New Hampshire Municipal Association. Dozens and dozens of moderators share notes, share citations to the statutes and so forth, and discuss these issues. And it looks like most of the state is considering what to do. By late last night, the strong consensus on that listserv was that it looks like most moderators are looking to postpone town elections tomorrow. It looks like this morning that the National Weather Service has upgraded us from storm watch to storm warning. And I hope I'm not letting any cats out of any bags, but apparently the emergency management folks are scheduling a conference call this morning. Under RSA 40:4, subparagraph 2, the town moderator is given the authority, the discretion, the unpleasant task of deciding whether or not to postpone an election or a what I'm calling now a business session of the town meeting. In other words, sometimes we refer to it as the deliberative session, but that gets confused with SB2. But it's really it's the meeting where other business is transacted other than the elections.
Can I interrupt you for just a minute?
Sure.
So the decision, if I heard you correctly, is yours to make as moderator.
It is.
Okay.
But
all right.
My reading of the statutes and my understanding of how decisions like this get made is that I really think that the chief, as the head of our emergency response process, the select board, as the body that initially has the statutory authority to designate what day the town meeting business session will occur, that it would be reckless for me not to confer with you. In other words, I do see this as a decision where it's open to criticism no matter what we do. And there are important, we have a couple of bonds, we have a contentious SB2 issue, we have contested races for budget committee, and in fairness to the voters, I don't think that the moderator should just kind of gaze at his or her navel and come up with a decision.
Well, I appreciate that, and I think that's why we're all here. So consultatively, we're going to talk this through, but in the final analysis, the decision will come from the moderator.
I think that's right.
That's how the process will work.
And Kate's paying for not agreeing to sit in front of the camera. I certainly think that the town clerk is an essential part of this because the logistics, as a moderator, I am incredibly lucky that the town clerk organizes all that she does to get poll workers, to coordinate with supervisors of checklists, to get counters and so forth. This is a pretty serious undertaking to get to organize an election and to postpone it strikes me as an important decision. So absolutely consulting. I would appreciate as many people who want to climb or put their necks in the noose with me, that would be very helpful, but I'll I get the whole of this bag, so.
Well, I'll just, you know, the weather sounds really, really difficult, and I hate, actually hate the idea that we're postponing because of weather, but this is, it's an unusual weather situation. So the other side of the coin that I'm thinking about and worrying about is if we find that we're going to need to postpone tomorrow, it, what I would like to see, if there's a way to get it so that we can have it before Saturday, so Saturday can continue as planned. Because we have bond warrants, as you know, the public hearing for which, you know, was supposed to take place within certain windows. And I don't know whether that throws things into some place where we don't want it to go if we have to also postpone the Saturday meeting. So,
I share both concerns. My recommendation is that we not hold elections tomorrow. It looks like the travel conditions, they just up this morning, the expected totals between 16 and 24 for us. Mm-hmm. So we're talking about and accumulations of 2 to 3 inches per hour during the afternoon, which suggests that it would be difficult, you know,
very difficult.
The chief's staff is going to be busy. I hope saving lives and not dealing with the ending of life, but they'll have to be useful, I suspect, as well as the road crews and so forth. So I think that the first part of the question is pretty easy, or easier. The difficulty, I conferred with Kate over the weekend. I know it's difficult for her to pull the election together before the weekend. And I've given a lot of thought, tried to review the statutes and put an inquiry into the Municipal Association. I don't see why we can't hold a town meeting, business meeting, before the elections occur. I hold the elections next Tuesday. I'm certainly open to contrary points of view and for people to tell me why that's not possible. But as I looked at, I sent it around in an email to you late last night. I apologize, I can't remember it. I think it's 39:2A or something like that. That when we split the business meeting off from the election day, we did it according to a statute, and the way that the ballot referendum was worded, it referred to a first session as the election and a second session as the business meeting. I think that was to clarify that there were two sessions. Mm-hmm. I don't know why there's a legal requirement that that the business meeting come after the election. The terms of all officers continue until their successors are in office. The purpose, and it occurred to me as I was driving over, I should go reread 40:4(2) again, but I think that refers to postponing a session. I think it's an election or a session. I think that's the way that the statute is worded. But I don't think that it envisions that postponing one part of the process envisions pushing the whole process out. I think that, and really what it talks about is what's reasonable. Mm-hmm. And in this instance where you've got important bond articles, you might want to confer if you can get, might be easier to get bond counsel actually today than either Secretary of State or New Hampshire Municipal, but it might be helpful if we could confirm.
I will check in with her.
Yeah, and certainly maybe confer with Steve. I hate to hand you all another legal bill, but I also have to be careful not to give you legal advice, particularly on something like a bond. That's just I'd be very quickly in the realm of malpractice. But my view of it from the moderator perspective is that I work, as I understand the law, to understand that this plain language of a statute binds us, but that in the absence of plain language, the purpose of the law is not to be an ass. In other words, sometimes the plain language forces us to do things that seem somewhat absurd. But I don't think that was ever the intention of the legislature. I think they wanted us to have, they wanted the world to work. And it seems to me like 40:4-2A is, or 2, is just exactly that kind of a law. It wants this process to work. It wants it to work in a safe way. And it wants people to be able to participate. And it strikes me that keeping the business meeting on Saturday the 18th gets us to that, gets us to that result. If there's contrary, like, I'm absolutely open. If there's somebody with contrary authority, I'll be happy to recede from that view. I'm also happy to reorganize. I have some travel plans for the 25th. I'm happy to reorganize those to be able to be present for a business meeting. And certainly if the board or the town clerk or the chief feels strongly that he should push the town, the business session as well, I'm happy to do that. Just to flesh out for the record a couple of my concerns about pushing the business meeting. So the bond has had these required hearings. The provision of postponing the election talks about what's reasonable for the election. It doesn't mention the other sessions, I don't think. It says you can postpone one or the other of the sessions.
But it doesn't say whether they have to maintain.
No, it doesn't say what
part A, part C. Yeah.
Yeah. And so I worry that that the concern in that's it's not frivolous. It's not frivolous to say that maybe these things ought to be elections first and then business session, because there is that language in the statute. But what I worry about is that there's an equally good argument that pushing off a meeting, a town meeting business session on a good day without a reasonable basis to do it, like I don't have, so my, the moderator's authority under 40:4 is when there's a reasonable belief that travel will be hazardous.
Mm-hmm.
I have no such belief that travel will be hazardous on
mm-hmm.
Saturday. And in that sense, it's kind of forcing me to be an ass. I apologize for the language, but it's forcing me to do something absurd to say, well, we couldn't possibly hold the business session on Saturday. Because for what purpose would we have to continue for what purpose does the business session have to follow the election, is the question I have.
Well, certainly, so, you know, as I was thinking about this, and I have been out of commission for much of the weekend, but...
Sorry, but...
Thank you. But as I have started thinking about this, the thing that worries me the most is moving the business part of the meeting because of when we had the public hearing on the bonds and that 60-day window that we have to maintain. I think it puts it out, or may put it out. We could do that calculation. We were close to the outer edge. So there's, there appears to be, you know, justification, as you say they may be, for us to count these as two separate pieces, and that one doesn't, the sequence is not necessarily bound by law, that certainly keeping town meeting on Saturday is high on my priority list.
Charlie, Caroline has been getting updates of other towns that are postponing it for Thursday. It wouldn't be easy. We could do it, but what is your schedule? Yeah. What is your schedule on Thursday?
I can make it work.
You could.
Can you make it work?
I don't know if I have a supervisor and I lose Andrea for the day, but I'll have to get busy.
I can be here.
A lot of times, like supervisors has to be a supervisor. They both work.
Well, understood. But if you need help, like what Andrea does, or.
Yeah. So let me just put that out there. I mean, we'll just have to move a little quickly, and but that would at least keep it.
So it removes that sort of question mark,
right.
Possible question mark.
Yep.
Right.
That would have a benefit if I might. Kate, in terms of the training for the tasks that those poll workers have to do, does the lower volume of the town election make it easier to do that training function, easier for somebody to kind of second chair it and keep an eye?
The book is the most important part, and I usually have Carrie and she's away, so I'm going to do the book myself. But there are times when, you know, I get interrupted or I have to step away for a minute, and it's just really important that we've only used a few individuals. Caroline would probably be a good fit if she's around. But, I mean, it's a 12-hour day. And then we are going to have residents that are upset because we're not going to be open in the office, and Thursday night is a busy night. So, I mean, it's going to be things like that, but it's out of our control at this point.
The weather is,
yeah.
The weather hits all of us.
We can only control the weather.
Well, I just spoke to a clerk. She's been a clerk for 30 years, and this is the first time it's happened in 30 years.
And I can make Thursday work as well. And it sounded a great option if we can make it work. But.
I'm in.
Okay. And I got to get busy. And I did talk with LHS, so.
Right.
So our machine and our ballots are all programmed for the 14th. So I just kind of wanted to get something in writing so that there is no one on the end of this election that is going to complain that, you know, the tape is going to be the 14th, the ballots are going to be the 14th.
Oh, I see. The readout is going to say that this was taking place on the 14th.
It can't be reprogrammed at this point. So, and it would be expensive. So I just want...
So
everyone
perhaps we
know.
Can have some certification that is associated with that.
That there's going to be a discrepancy.
You know, some of the last
notarized. Yeah.
In the moderator.
Charlie, the board, whoever should can certify that.
Right. Those dates would be incorrect. But that hasn't been altered at all.
Right.
So where are we then?
Thanks again, everyone, for their consultation. My view is that unless there is an objection that we need to explore further, but my view is that we postpone tomorrow's election to Thursday and keep the business section for Saturday.
I agree.
Excellent. Very good. And Kate, if you need some folks, let us know, and we'll beat the bushes. I mean, there.
Yeah, I just have to be very, very cautious with the book. I've learned in the past. At the end of the evening, my book has to match the machine. And the minute you get someone in who
I'm
gets
very
disoriented,
careful.
Okay. I just
so
nervous about that, but we'll.
Last minute here. What's going to be the cutoff time, Charlie, that we're going to make this final decision, let people know? Because we need to get the word out as quick as possible that the election's been postponed.
Good question, Mike. And it's something we haven't really fully discussed, is how we notify people. My view is the more notice we can give, the better participation that we can get, and the purpose of what we're trying to do is to promote the fullest possible opportunity for voters to exercise their constitutional right. So it seems to me that the question about the bond issue is gone, because we're going to keep the sequence. We're going to keep the sequence, and as far as we know, there's no mandatory amount of time between the election and the business session. So I would say we make the decision now and discuss how we will notify the public. And I know that we have some representatives from a couple of different taxpayer groups, but I assume that they have social media ability to contact their supporters.
Judy Curry has contacted me. She'd like to know the paper.
Good.
So our town website fosters the radio.
Yeah.
Channel 9.
Yeah.
And we'll do a Nixle alert as well.
We'll do a Nixle alert.
The yellow town signs, do you want to put a notice on there too as well, like a bright colored paper notice on those yellow town signs that are out?
What yellow town signs?
The ones that say vote
Tuesday.
Tuesday?
Did we put those out?
Yes. they're town, they're on the town sandwich boards.
Okay.
They're in a couple of key locations.
All right, so yeah, we should.
A bright colored sign today, because, you know, everybody will drive by at some point.
We should probably take the sandwich boards down through the weather anyways.
Actually, we have to take, yeah, we, yeah, they're not gonna be able to stay during the.
And then put them out Wednesday, correct?
Yeah.
What about getting a mailer out today, getting created today, it would be in everybody's mailbox tomorrow. And then they'll have it tomorrow.
What's the expense? I mean, that's expensive.
Well,
About $400.
You know, our budget's been slashed. Is it, can it really, so, so let's, if we bring this over to the post office today, it will be in people's mailboxes when?
Well, he can hand cancel it. You can ask Kevin to not process it through Manchester. He hand cancels it, it goes out the same day.
I mean, they would need to have it Wednesday in order for it to be effective, right?
I'm thinking of all those people that are not on, is the best way to reach them.
All the people what?
That are not on the computer.
Well, that's, we're doing radio, we're doing TSN, you know, we're doing that. I mean, if we're doing mailers that go to everybody, it removes perhaps the, well, no, because we don't want people trying to show up on Tuesday. We still need to do all these other things.
Yeah.
I think, you know, the majority, the group of people who vote, and we have the same group of people who vote that I've seen for elections for years, are pretty in tune to what's going on. I'd be very surprised if somebody woke up in a blizzard and thought that we were having an election that day.
Hey, I gotta go vote.
We could notify the school, which is, quite a few parents.
You can all call Pollyanna, but if I could make a recommendation that our notices say, tell your neighbor. Because it's like, this is a small town, and if we can kind of rebuild some of that social capital, I can't run my cell phone, so I would appreciate it if my neighbor
called. Well, I think it's common sense, and people will all be watching the news, and it will be on there, and it's not just Rollinsford. They're going to see that all the small towns have moved it. So I guess the question will be, when is it, more than it'll be people trying to show up on Tuesday to vote.
And still Thursday, second, seventh.
Yeah.
All right, so where are we then with the mailer? Are we thinking that it might be sufficient to do the all these other channels that we've talked about?
I think so.
And then the voting groups will get out their own word, and I don't see a problem with, I'm sure people will be putting out their own signs, move to Thursday, and I'm sure with the camaraderie of the town, like putting something up on your yard, don't forget, it's Thursday, we'll probably see a lot of those.
I don't
know. Is that the same?
Like, you can't put it in
the snowbank
anyway.
Yeah, the sandwich boards may not be operative. There's no place. There's no place to put them out even afterwards, depending on where the snow, where the banks are.
They're going to be pretty high up.
It'll be very high sandwich boards, I think.
Yeah. All right.
Before you all adjourn, Kate is now on the phone with the Secretary of State's office in case they have any more pertinent information.
Okay.
That is the state, they say we cannot postpone the town meet, vote.
Oh.
Secretary of State?
Yes, you can.
She's got legal terms. She's got the RSA.
You can reach her in the conference room. There's a phone. That's,
find out. I said, and you've announced this throughout the state for people who were trying to postpone it.
I thought some towns have already moved.
Some have.
Yeah, some have.
We were all waiting for them.
What's the, and what the heck is the penalty? But the problem for us is on the,
oh my goodness.
You can vote or die. Die,
vote for your die, right? We're gonna die. We'll be free. The last storm that was like this, I actually had an appointment in Portland, and I'm like, oh, I'm going to Portland. No one's gonna stop me. I literally made it to 236, and it took me like 3 hours to get back. But you can't drive.
Yeah. We're gonna be out there shoveling instead of in here, making sure.
Gotta get my snowshoes out.
Do we have cots upstairs?
We can't go upstairs.
Oh.
We're not allowed to walk up there.
This is gonna
so
just go
here's
right
my little notice that we can put on the website and everywhere else. To the voters of the town of Rawlinsburg, town elections have been postponed, caps, from Tuesday, March 14th to Thursday, March 16th, from 7:00 a.m. to 7:00 p.m. at Town Hall.
Don't post it yet.
I'm not, but at least I'm trying to get that
yeah.
language. Very simple.
Now, from what you know, she said quickly to me that is that you can postpone the meeting part of it, but not the election part of it. So somebody found an RSA that reads that. So, like Charlie
so
said,
we can postpone
what's
Saturday,
the penalty
not today?
So what,
tomorrow.
So if we do it, what you know, what's the penalty? $50 fine or?
I'll pay the $50 fine if that's what it is.
When he went over, he said, so what's the penalty? Like a $50 fine? It might be worth it.
Just from the reinforcement, you may pay your Mr. Beck.
But when she started stating all the RSAs and the legal stuff, I thought Charlie got it.
Yep.
I better get my minestrone and soup going. I thought I had an extra day to make it.
Your part-timers, Chief?
Pardon me?
So that means you're probably going to have to bring in all your part-timers.
No, I'm just planning on two of us.
Okay. Well, I won't need much help because people aren't going to come.
But if, you know what I mean? If nobody else can
do
it.
Okay. Okay. It's the required people that I have.
Sorry.
Right.
Right. Yeah, I would imagine. Right. Yeah. So, yes.
The sad thing about this is that all the towns are in the same position, and they're going to make a decision, and then the state emergency is going to make another decision.
State emergency is going to say everybody off the roads.
Right.
See, in the morning, first thing in the morning, you can slam and then it'll be dead.
Fire chief already said to stay off the road. Put a new
pistol. Gotta love it.
I'm glad you heard it like I heard it.
Gotta love it. They are insistent. I mean, Bill sometimes takes these kinds of positions.
Yes, he does.
And it's a position he took, I guess, apparently back in the 80s. So.
For a presidential primary election, 1984, is that not a federal election, it's a state election.
And
is he going to disqualify the election results for the town of Rawlinsburg and every other town in the area if we hold the election on Thursday?
Well, I don't mean to have small p politics intrude on you, but I worry for you on your, well, of course it's, I was going to say I was worrying for you on the bond issues, but the bond issues are going to be done at the business meeting, and the legal argument for saying that because you know if somehow the election was not properly held, then that therefore the action of the town meeting on the properly noticed day is somehow invalid. That's pretty weak tea for a court, but I would encourage you to confer with C. Roberts on that.
Bond counsel too.
And bond counsel on that as well. They gave me the main line. This directly contradicts what Dave
Scanlon.
Dave
Scanlon, the Deputy Secretary of State.
Yeah. Told another moderator again, I can picture, so this was reported as something, and again, sorry for the politics aspect of it, is Speaker Jasper and Secretary of State Bill Gardner saying this. They've now apparently lined up the workers to say that. I don't know where, that probably means that they will toe the party line, but it also contradicts what municipal associations have been saying. There are dozens and dozens of moderators, including Jim Belanger, who's
also a legislator,
yeah. Saying that, that you know, it's nuts to make people come out in particularly dangerous weather conditions.
Well, if you have advisors that say stay off the roads.
The statute clearly says you have the discretion to postpone the election.
Yep.
And any time I've called the state on other issues for this election, they've said we don't get involved in town elections.
Yeah.
However, now they're involved. What is the penalty, Charlie? What happens if we do move it?
I'll have to take a look. There's one of the penalties where the select board commits a misdemeanor. or a violation. I'll see visit you in jail. But you know, I don't think they punish the moderators. So I rather just keep
as long as you and I are out of this.
The bug always stops here.
So public safety be damned. We have to have the election one way or another, according to Billy Gardner.
I think that's
ridiculous.
I think that's his position. What I'd like to do, I mean, this disrupts our intention to notify people early.
Mm-hmm.
What I'd like to do is to try to get in touch with the New Hampshire Municipal Association and see if there's any possibility that they can talk some sense to Bill Gardner.
Well, I think the only other thing, you have to go to the Supreme Court, right? An election issue, then they will allegedly hear it right away.
Or I wish that I were
not us, but the municipal association
well should. Connected with the AG because I think the AG would be happy to. I'll see if I can pull in a call to Ian Rice, who's the deputy still. This is kind of a remarkable position for them to take.
I would think.
Can we? I hate to.
You were out of the room when I just fashioned a very succinct notice. To the voters of the town of Rollinsford, town elections have been postponed from Tuesday, March 14th to Thursday, March 16th from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. at Town Hall. And we'll just, you know, once we have the okay, we can start to notify those channels.
I think, just so that, I forget Colleen's last name. She tried to tell me, and then I confounded it with another last name. But apparently, their interpretation of Chapter 669:1, is that elections are prescribed by statute, and elections must be on the second Tuesday of March, and there's no chance to change it. And I said, well, but RSA 669:3, brings in, you know, talks about the warrant and says that provisions of the warrant are subject to Chapter 39 and RSA 40 modifies Chapter 39. And she was like, well, elections are not part of the town meeting. And I'm like, elections are part of the town meeting. She says, elections aren't part of the town meeting. So I think that the legal argument is that by setting up Chapter 669, now elections are something separate from town meeting.
Our warrant clearly has the elections, as, you know, it's all one, it's all the piece with the election piece and then
and that's when she said, well, I was a town clerk in the 1980s and Bill took this position in the 1980s. So, let me see what I can find out. The alternative that we not have elections doesn't work. And Mike, your point is well taken. It's like, what's if there was an action that would be legally defective by postponing the elections, but really it's who's going to be select person, who's going to be on the budget committee, and SB, well, SB 2 is a big, that's a big issue. So either side that loses on SB 2 can say that I was wrong, and this, you know, this was all wrong and a travesty and so forth as a means of, you know.
Well, they could probably, they could say that if it's held tomorrow or if it's held Thursday. Either side that loses.
I think either way, whatever side loses, they'll argue it and it'll be back on the ballot next year.
Yep.
And for public safety, I don't, public safety is way more important.
I agree.
So.
Safety and the franchise.
Yeah.
Yeah, both, they're both really important, and we jeopardize both, I think, if we try to hold them Tuesday.
I don't want to jeopardize my neighbor
just for what?
Yeah, for one piece of paper.
She knows where to arrest me, so, you know, he can pick
yeah,
me up.
Of
all
people,
right,
no,
we're all
looking
at
each other.
We'll be gentle.
Well, it's just, you know, keeping the parking lot clear, and what if we lose power? And,
yeah.
I mean, it just doesn't
make sense.
Well,
we'll have power in this building.
With the generator?
With the generator, we'll have power in this building.
People won't be able to park.
But people won't be able to park. You'll have to have someone in the transfer station or one of the workers to continuously shovel out there.
Mm-hmm.
You can't have that get covered with snow. But there's going to be a parking issue. And in the event that, we do have a sustained power outage, I may have to kick all of you out of this room anyway and say this is now our temporary shelter for folks in town that need to come and stay warm.
Mm-hmm.
So,
God. Who'd have thought?
And they,
can sleep
and they
right.
Actually, you know, they said you absolutely
yeah.
Can't.
If we set them
shorten
up.
Shorten the allowed by statute, so you can't shorten the.
There are towns that hold their town elections in May. The town of Stoddard does it.
Yeah, there's another.
Yeah, that's another.
So how does Colleen from Secretary of State's office jive with that? Then?
There's
every election has to be held on a Tuesday in March.
No, there are alternative sessions.
Unless you have adopted the provisions of RSA such and such that has the May.
Right.
Crazy.
But it is crazy. Are you comfortable waiting till maybe noon?
Yes.
We have to.
Mm.
I'd like to just see if I can. It's going to take some luck to get the AG and the Municipal Association, but I'd like to try. But at the end of the day, the moderators had considered this question about like what's the punishment, and I think it's like slap on the hand to me, and I can say if the voters are unhappy with the decision I made, I stand, you know, I'll stand by it, and they can make another choice for moderator. That's you know, like that that's how the process works.
Mm-hmm.
I worry just a little bit. I forget what it is that I saw for the select board that. It may be a violation, but you know there's something for the select board on following the requirements. I think 39, the chapter 39, but that's not well. I shouldn't get into giving you guys legal advice. I think the moderator's listserv was fine, punish us. You know. This is not a situation where we want voters to help.
Especially when they've told us repeatedly that they don't get involved in town elections.
We're going to ask elderly voters, tell them that they're not allowed to apply for an absentee ballot today because of weather, and then require them to come out tomorrow. And so even if the storm's supposed to start tomorrow morning,
mm-hmm.
We're going to ask them to drive out in that weather, or anyone in particular, but I mean, especially elderly drivers and voters. It's unconscionable. I'm fine with moving the third one. Billy Gardner can come rescue himself.
I agree with Mike.
Same here.
Done.
You can visit us all in jail.
Yeah, I didn't hear anything about town clerk, though. What did she get?
Yeah, you're up there.
Oh, no.
State prison.
Well, good. I mean, you know what? They do my laundry.
We
get medication, three square
meals. The noon statewide call today, so maybe the Secretary of State and the AG may participate in that call. Hopefully, because I'm sure we're not the only one that made a phone call and said, hey, you know, we may get punished if we move the election. So hopefully, maybe at the noon call, somebody will address that.
Okay. All right. So officially not until noon. We'll wait to hear what you have to say.
Officially.
Perfect. Thank you.
And also,